Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So today we're gonna be doing a little Q&A with questions that you guys have been asking me over time through Instagram or Twitter or Facebook or whatever social media platform that you use to contact me. So I have the questions pulled up here on my computer and I'm gonna be answering them throughout this video. So if you're interested on it, just keep on watching. So the first question that I have been asked a lot is what ballet dancers, male ballet dancers are called, because we know that female ballerinas are called ballerinas, and a lot of people think that the male term for that is ballerinos, but it's not. We ourselves call to male dancers, I guess, ballet dancer or danseur, which is a French term, but we didn't really use that term. We just say ballet dancer. And the next question is, what do ballet dancers do when we are not on a stage? So I guess this is depending on the person, but in my case, I'm in a school. So what I do is that when I have free time, I basically study, I watch my classes because they are online, university, so I can watch the classes online, and that's pretty much what I do. When I'm on tour with Ballet Trocadero, if depending on the city where we are, sometimes I go to museums. I like to explore the cities. If we go to countries that are really interesting, like Japan, we normally go to temples and we go shopping, which is a really great activity, not good for the pocket, but I love shopping, and that's pretty much what we do. Like, just regular things. We go to the movie theaters, we go to grab drinks with friends, watch a lot of TV. I watch a lot of Netflix, a lot. And also, in my company in specific, me in specific, I sew ponchos. That's like my favorite activity to do, to put some Netflix and sew some ponchos, because, you know, we gotta be ready for the shows. The next two questions are a little bit tricky, because the first one is how long it takes to become a professional ballet dancer. It's depending on the person. I know people that they have started late in life, like in their teenager years, like 15, 16, and they have successful careers. In my case, I started when I was 3 years old. I was lucky that my parents like needed to put me in an extracurricular activity, and they, I chose to dance, and my parents were okay with it. So I started at 3 years old, and it took me a lot of years to become a professional dancer. I guess even though you become a professional, you never stop learning. I think that I learn every single day new things, not in terms of vocabulary and steps, but in terms of like perfection, trying to make the steps perfect, which is never the case because perfection doesn't exist. But that's the goal. And I guess, like, I don't know, I graduated when I was 22. And you can say that at the age of 22, I became a professional. But yeah, it took me all those years to even say I was a professional dancer. And after that, you keep studying, because, you know, it's the body what you're studying on, and body's never the same. You wake up every day differently. So it seems that, you know, I mean, obviously, you know the steps and you know the vocabulary and you know what's going on. But at the same time, you don't know what's going on with your body every day. So every day you need to do a checklist to see what is hurting, what is not hurting, what do you have to get better at, what do you have to practice more. Also, because when you're a professional dancer, I feel that when you get into a company, you focus on getting better and better every day. But at the same time, you're also focusing on the shows that you have to do. So I guess like you put short-term goals, where if you have to do, in my case, let's say that I have to do Swan Queen. Never did in the company yet, but let's say that I have to do Swan Queen. Well, obviously I'm gonna focus more on my adagio, on my arm movement, on those aspects that are really peculiar about Swan Lake. And I think that those are my goals, you know, like short-term goals, because you have certain ballets that you have to do, so you focus on what you are doing in that ballet in specific, if that makes sense. And last but not least, how long a dancer's career lasts. I think it's depending of what your goals are in your life. I think in our company, Valley Trocadero, we have people that they are 21, but we also have people that have 43, 44 years old. I think it's depending on what you want in your life and where are you at, depending on the age you have. In my case, I'm almost 30 years old. This year, I turned 30. But I think that I have many more years of career. And I think it's depending on what your body can handle. If you have 45 years old, but your body can still perform and execute ballets in a totality and grade, I feel that in our company, for example, that's welcome. You can stay in the company. But I know that in traditional ballet companies, it's quite more difficult to get promoted and stuff like that. So I understood that some people around like the age of 35 to 40 is when they are like, okay, it's time to move on. But I guess it's depending on the company that you're at, depending on what you want to dance, depending what you're willing to give up in your career in order to keep dancing, you know what I mean? Like when you have certain age, you obviously cannot execute certain ballets the same way that you did when you were 21 or 22 or 30. So obviously I guess insights in the company, what is good for the company to portray, they will put you in a role or another role. But it's not how people think. People think that our career is like Olympic Games. Once you are 19, you're over and you're done. Actually, nowadays, people are getting hired in companies way later. Like before, it was normal to see 16, 17, 18 year olds in companies. But obviously now, I feel that to perform, you need a maturity that only age give you. And I feel that some directors in some companies have realized that yes, it's cute to have the little cute teenager look dancers in the company because it's young and it's fresh. But at the same time, talking about ballerinas, a 17-year-old ballerina, even if she technically is perfect, she's not going to be able to give to a role like mature, like, for example, Kitri in Don Quixote. A 17-year-old is not going to be able to do the same Kitri than a 25-year-old, just basically because of age. When you are 25, you have some experience in life and you have gone through stuff in your life, some boyfriends, some even marriages sometimes. And when you're 17, you're extremely innocent still. So I don't think that the interpretation of certain ballets are going to be accurate. So yeah, that's basically it. It's depending of what you're capable of doing, whatever age you are. Okay guys, so that's all for today. I hope you guys like this little Q&A, some random questions that I've been asked for a long time. If you want to know something else, just, you know, go to my social media, which is down below, and click the button to subscribe to my channel. And don't forget to push the bell so you can get a notification whenever I upload videos. And I hope you guys are great. Please be safe out there and just be happy. Mwah! See you next time.